And welcome. This is Mary Ellen McGonigal with your weekly MEM Edge show, brought to you each and every Friday afternoon with an eye toward putting you in front of where the action is in the markets. And even more importantly, helping you prepare not only for the upcoming week, but beyond. So lots of to cover, certainly an exciting week in the markets. Let's take a look at what we're going to be reviewing today. As usual, we are going to take a look at the current markets, drill down, see where they are. Again, looking toward the future with that. Also, screening candidates into these newer areas. And this is the third week that we have been discussing the rotation into some of those earlier beaten down areas of the market, and they really are firming up tremendously. So a lot of them big pops, and we're going to take a look at how you can screen for candidates in these areas that are really coming on quite strongly here of late. Also, a lot of stocks have had really significant rallies today in particular. So I'm going to share with you how you can handle those stocks. Number one, if you happen to be in them, or if you have not, perhaps a lot of these names gapped up and did not do much for the rest of the day. How do you handle them going forward? So we'll take a look at that using examples. And then pullbacks among growth stocks. Growth stocks lagged this week, and I'm going to share with you how to determine whether it's a pullback or something more, and ideal ways to play the pullback, for lack of better wording. I always like to start by sharing some of the more impactful headlines this week that'll help provide a frame for what occurred. We did see, of course, very bullishly surprising news today. U.S. adds 2.5 million jobs. So that came really on the heels of earlier bullish news. So really has investors excited. In the way of technology stocks, semiconductor chips up all over 8%. And a lot of that has to do with chip sales on the rise, and also bullish pre-announcements from a couple of the heavyweight semiconductor companies. We'll get into that. Also, U.S. manufacturing did show an increase in May. So that's another bullish backdrop. And then all 50 states are now in some stage of reopening. Of course, this is the cause and of a lot of the optimism surrounding the markets. And then we're also seeing COVID-19 cases in the U.S. continue to trend downward. So this is the backdrop. Certainly some of the more important headlines leading into this rally week that we've just experienced. So let's go ahead and drill down, take a look at the markets. This is a daily price chart of the S&P 500, and we are very much in a confirmed uptrend. Those of you that watch each and every week, you'll know that I am on the prowl for this type of bullish action prior to that bear market, where we are finding support at an upward trending shorter term 10-day simple moving average. That's going to be your green line. And of course, we do also want the longer term 50-day simple moving average, the red line, to be in an uptrend. And we are experiencing that. So lots of super bullish signals in play right now. On the daily chart, the RSI this week did pop into that overbought condition. That's above 70. So we are overbought. However, we can go back historically and see that the RSI can retain and remain above this 70 and beyond for quite some time. So it's more of an alert, a yellow flag, if you will, but certainly nothing to be alarmed about. Stochastics up here, once they did come up here above the 80, and they actually did so last month, stochastics are a bit earlier in their signals. So it is also in this overbought position. But again, we can go back historically and see stochastics can remain up there for some time. One additional item to pay attention to is the position of in this case, the S&P. You can do this for individual stocks as well as other indices. Take a look at the position of that relative to the 10-day simple moving average. And very clearly, we are stretched. I'll give more detail in my MEM Edge report over the weekend as to where we are relative to historical standards, but it is definitely worth noting as a signal for a potential pullback. Let's go ahead and drill down further as we do get into some of these sectors so we can point out even in a more defined way the rotation that has been taking place over the last several weeks. What we have here are the 11 S&P 500 sectors, and I've gone ahead and added the RSI indicator in descending order. I want to see strength to weakness among these sectors. So we can see up here, basic materials up here in the forefront. The group was up about 8% for the week, so very, very strong. But here are these newer areas. We can see industrials. Industrial stocks were up 11% this week, and we'll drill down, uncover precisely why, and look at a couple of the stocks within there. Consumer discretionary still up here in the forefront, had a more modest 6% advance, but it was still outperformed the broader markets. And then from here, we can see financials. This is another area that we've been highlighting over the last 2 weeks as it just turned bullish. I'll share with you precisely why. Back here, we can see that it actually more currently this week, financials have broken back up above this 200-day simple moving average, which oftentimes can act as resistance. Take a look at the volume. This is a daily price chart of XLF, the financial sector. Huge volume, nice price break above this blue 200-day. So very bullish action there. That's one of the areas I'm going to share with you how to screen for candidates. And then moving along, we can see energy, technology a bit more modest in its return this week, little less than the S&P, but ahead of the NASDAQ. Still real pockets of strength in there. We talked about semiconductors being certainly one of them. Real estate stocks, these are REITs, higher yielding, also outperformed, up 7% this week. We're going to be sharing how you can screen for candidates in the REIT stocks as well. And as we move on, we can see healthcare really continuing to, I want to say disappoint, but the group was flat this week. Biotech stocks, strong earlier in this rally, have receded a bit. So we are seeing general malaise among healthcare stocks. Worth noting could be that the defensive nature among a lot of the medical stocks is no longer needed with this broadening out and lifting of other areas, and certainly the optimistic bullishness that is surrounding us. So let's go ahead. Of course, we do want to drill down further into some of the other indices and industry groups, certainly that I like to follow. My focus is going to be on higher growth areas of the market. And this is a view of some of the underlying indexes. So again, RSI descending, and we can see transports up here very much in the forefront. Airline stocks really having an exceptional week as travel is beginning to take shape, and it's joining the already strong trucking and rail areas that we pointed out 2 weeks ago. So lots of bullish action in the transports. This, of course, is good. It's constructive. It indicates an economy that is on the move and will be on the move even more going forward. This is the Dow Jones Industrial. Let's take a quick look. I want to share with you. This is another index that very decisively and bullishly broke back above this 200-day simple moving average. Huge volume. So the Dow is joining the party, if you will. The S&P and NASDAQ have, of course, been above those key areas for quite some time now. Let's move on. We can see IWM, that's the Russell 2000 small cap stocks, up 8%. Another bullish signal because it also broke back above this 200-day simple moving average. A move into small cap stocks is a signal of risk tolerance being raised, the concept that these smaller businesses may, in fact, do well going into a recovering economy. So very bullish action there as well. Here we are with semiconductors up here in the forefront. Super big move. Let's just take a quick look at this chart. We can see it is a bit extended. So in addition to a global report citing a pickup and actual increase in year-over-year semiconductor chip sales last month, also was joined by, I mentioned, bullish pre-announcements of earnings of a couple of bellwether names. So really quite constructive within semiconductor stocks. And then as we drill down, we can see gold losing its luster as these other areas move to the forefront. So that's your broader market view. What I do want to do from here is go ahead and share with you this way that you can screen for some of these stocks that are really on the move. We can take a very quick look. In fact, I'm not sure why this didn't show up, but let's take a look at Energy XLE. This is the group chart. I'm going to go ahead and pull up a weekly on this so I can share with you really just how powerfully strong, up 16%. For the week, and a lot of underlying stocks up even more. So as an investor, that could be certainly a bit daunting. You may very easily think that the move is behind you. But let's go ahead and take a look among the S&P 500, because a lot of the move in energy today was a big day. And we can see among the top movers today, this is from stockcharts.com, it's sharing with me those names that were up the most today. And you can see it's just littered with these energy names. OXY is Occidental, Apache, and then down further we have Devon. So we can take a quick look at this candle glance view. And what I did want to share with you as a way to potentially participate or even get your arms around some of these significant movers. So here we are looking at OXY. This is Occidental Petroleum, and it was up 34% today, but huge volume. So what I want to share with you is this an intraday. In fact, we're going to drill down to a 15-minute price chart. This is going to be for certainly educational purposes and for those that are more active in the markets, what you can be on the prowl for. On the open today, of course, the employment numbers came out prior to the open, but you certainly wouldn't know that energy was going to be one of the bigger winners. But keeping an eye on that percent up, OXY showed up very quickly because take a look at this gap up on the open this morning. So if you are looking at this 15-minute price chart, I have a 5 and a 13 simple moving average. If you are interested or think that this stock, certainly given the volume, would have more upside, most traders, ideally, you're going to want to wait past that 15-minute period and take a look at that second bar. Is that next 15-minute period surpassing that initial gap up? Are we seeing continued volume? And we did, in fact, get that. So that's your confirmation for further upside with a stock that is gapping up with this kind of a powerful move. So now we have a stock that has gone up 33%. What the heck do you do with it now? So I will argue with you on this short-term 15-minute chart. There is further upside ahead. The stock is retaining its presence above these shorter-term simple moving averages. It closed this last 15-minute period, big volume, nice up bar, RSI, MACD in positive territory. So that said, what I want it to do is go back, share with you a couple of other stocks that had really big gaps up, and these were more earnings related. But before we do that, I'm going to take us back to a daily chart, just to give you relevance as to where this stock is in relationship to historical. It does have a bit in the way of overhead. So it's not going to be an exact science as far as using history, because the dynamics are very different, but yet similar. We're going to take a look at Chegg, CHGG. This stock actually gapped up huge but it was on earnings. This is a 32% gap up. It was up as high as 38% before pulling back. And again, during that period, a lot of people would think that you had missed the move. But take a look on this daily. It did advance another 17% more before its current pullback period, but still in bullish standing on the daily. So one dynamic to make note of that is different is this gap up was on earnings and it catapulted the stock to new highs, which is quite bullish. But let's go ahead and drill down into an intraday using history as a guide. 15-minute won't take me back that far, so I'm going to go back to a 30-minute chart. Here's that gap up on May 5th. And we can see this really got into an overbought position. We're not quite there with OXY, but what you will see with the stocks following their gap up, you can stay with it on this 30-minute. As long as this RSI stays up here above this net neutral, we can see that it had another couple of days of upside action. But again, as long as your RSI and MACD are in positive territory, you are in good standing. It's when we begin to break down. The RSI is now below that net neutral. The MACD is below that net neutral. So this is taking us to that May 18th. Let's go back to the daily so we can get a little more reference there. But it is taking us to this period, not the end of the world, but this is your pullback. So that what I'm pointing out to you here is the concept of using those intraday in these stocks that have had these parabolic moves. It's really going to give you that extra layer, that extra added piece of information that, of course, can be really quite helpful. So that was one item I did want to share with you. We're going to take a little bit of a break right now. When we get back, I'm going to share with you really succinct ways to screen for candidates in the REITs and financials in particular, but what I'm sharing with you, you can carry into other groups as well. So we will be right back. During every bull market, there are a select set of stocks that far outpace their peers. They trade much higher and much faster than the rest of the markets. The reason? These select stocks have a set of characteristics that history has proven are common among big winning stocks. My easy-to-follow course will teach you the skills of a lifetime so you can learn how to uncover and then successfully trade these fast-moving stocks. Take my five-part course now by going to meminvestmentresearch.com for this limited time offer. And we are back. I'm sharing with you here a daily price chart of the real estate sector. XLRE is the ticker symbol. This sector really got damaged in this bear market. It was down 40% peak to trough. A lot of concerns, very valid, surrounding real estate as far as commercial, residential, and elsewhere, because the since we didn't know how long lockdown, and we still are uncertain there, as far as corporate leases, and then of course residential, and then hotel, travel REITs all got really damaged. We did have a little bit, certainly a very significant rally here into mid-April before faltering again. But more recently, this is over the last 2 weeks, with today's action being that bullish breakup above that 200-day, there are two ways that you can screen for stocks in this, what I call newer area. It's joining technology and some of the other early movers. One is looking for stocks that are just beginning their downtrend reversal. They're a little bit earlier. And then the other is to screen for those stronger stocks that preceded this break up above that 200 and are already in bullish standing. So let me go ahead and share with you one way that you can, in fact, screen for this. This is a service called FinBiz, and I'm sharing it with you simply because I find it easy. There's certainly stockcharts.com has very, very similar screening where you can look for stocks in a given industry group. So I've gone ahead and asked for real estate. I want the price to currently be above that 20-day simple moving average, above the 50-day simple moving average. However, show me those stocks that are 20% below that 200-day simple moving average. So we are on the prowl here for stocks that are, I would say, just beginning that potential downtrend reversal. So let's take a look at some of these candidates that did, in fact, emerge as potentially being in the more beginning stages of this turnaround. One particular name is Store Capital. They are in that real estate space. So with this particular stock, you can see that it had a nice early advance above the shorter term simple moving averages. But it wasn't until this week that we started to get a more confirmed move, more volume, and this 50-day, the longer term moving average, beginning to trend upward. So what we have here is a stock trading at 25, and the next possible area of resistance is 31, which is where this 200-day simple moving average. Now, as an example, we can look at other stocks that are potentially below those moving averages that would hit the screen but are not as interesting. This is Sun Communities SUI. We can see that it is up here pressing at that 200-day simple moving average. Ideally, I would like to see that stock break up above that 200-day in a bullish fashion. So that is that particular screen. And as you can do in stockcharts.com, you can go ahead and hover over the ticker symbol. We can take a quick look at SPG. I sorted that list by market cap. I want to see the more liquid names. SPG is Simon Property Group, and very similar to STOR as far as this big volume characteristic as it continues to advance up to this next possible area of resistance. So let's take a look at an additional way. I talked about screening for stocks that are bullish as far as being above their 200-day simple moving average. So we can do that with real estate stocks. I have already had done it for the banking area. We'll go ahead and cover that area next. But here we are. These are those stocks, 47 names that are bullishly above all of their key simple moving averages. Sort it by market cap. So these are your winners. A lot of these are 5G digital center related. And we can just take a quick look at a couple of the names here, just as a point of reference. This is American Tower, AMT, much different looking as it relates to relative to being well above those simple moving averages and in a bullish position. EQIX also came up. This is a digital center related REIT, but more bullish and a candidate because after hitting a new high, has pulled right back to this upward trending 50-day simple moving average. So let's go ahead and do the same exercise with bank stocks. Just again, to give you that feel, above the 20, above the 50 simple moving average, 20% or more below that 200-day simple moving average, a quick sort by market cap. A lot more banking stocks that are below than above their simple moving averages, but we can take a look at a couple of these candidates. Let's go back because I do like the charting much better on stockcharts.com. Here is one of those down and out candidates, WSBC, and we can see this initial downtrend reversal met with resistance at that 50, but now we very decisively have broken up above it. Nice volume today, 7% rally. This green line poised to go up through the red, that's your golden cross where the shorter term moving average breaks above the longer term. And we can see that the stock is very much on its way to reversing this downtrend, with this 200-day simple moving average being your next area of upside resistance. We do have we're just close to breaking above this overhead supply here, which is constructive. WSBC does have a 5.1% yield. Let's take a look. I've gone ahead and done the work for you as far as going through some of those candidates. Here is another one, again, above shorter term moving averages, but below the longer term. PACW, PacWest. There is a theme here because a lot of the banks in the western part of the US are starting to emerge, if you will. So we can see that today's 9% advance with PACW broke out of this 1 month, actually 6 week base. Huge volume characteristics, and we can see the RSI and MACD. Now, again, that 9% rally may be off-putting, but it is certainly well below that next area of possible upside resistance. This is where that intraday chart can really be helpful as far as guiding you on super near-term action, whether you should, in fact, enter the stock. The only of those large center banks down and out is Wells Fargo, WFC, and we can see that it is huge volume on today's 5% advance. MACD just turning positive, RSI is positive. So that's the down and out view. Let's go ahead and take a look at some of those bank stocks that are bullishly above all of their simple moving averages. I'm going to take a look at some of these regional banks. Really only 34 names are coming up. I mentioned that a lot of the banks, really, this is another area that truly did get beaten down. But let's go ahead. I'm going to share with you some of the stocks that came up on this screen in the newer financial space. This is Prosperity Bank PB. We can see the stock gapped up out of this 1 week base, nice volume. Another candidate that is also in bullish territory among these regional banking stocks is FFIN. Nice breakup above these simple moving averages. RSI, MACD is positive. And then a lot of the money center banks, they've emerged a bit earlier. This is actually JPM is below, but I did want to share with you a couple of names that are above. And this is Goldman Sachs. We are poised to have that 10-day simple moving average cross up above the 200. RSI and MACD are in positive territory. But with all of these names, you want to make sure that you don't chase these stocks. We can see earlier periods of bullishness where the stock did pull back, but again, using that intraday as your guide can really lend you that extra layer of confidence, if you will. So that is the screening for these newer areas, one of many ways that you can do so, but I thought would be really quite useful. Let's talk now about this concept of leading growth stocks. Again, we did see a lot of strength throughout the markets, but I wanted to share with you this concept of a pullback and where you can identify a buy point. This is Dexcom. DXCM had been a leader in this diabetic medical supply space, and we can see that the stock had hit a new high, but take a look. It is seemingly finding support here at this upward trending 50-day simple moving average. However, I would not be bullish until it breaks back above the 10 and until that RSI turns positive. Before we leave, I'll share with you an example that did just that, CHWY. This is from that MEM Edge report. We identified the stock as a buy on the pullback, and it has since broken above these shorter-term simple moving averages. I have a lot of other candidates on my MEM Edge report and lots more in the way of insights. So please take a four-week trial, use the tab below, and you'll be able to get access it for 4 weeks at a very nominal fee. For those of you in the markets, happy trading and have a great weekend.
Hey guys, Grayson Rose here with StockCharts.com. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Remember, if you did, give us a like down below, leave us a comment, we'd love to hear from you, and most importantly, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for daily content from an incredible collection of technical analysts and financial minds. We'll see you back here very soon. Happy charting, my friends.